Hello guys, welcome to Kingdom Theory Channel. In this occasion, I would like to deliver you a topic about the location of Sriwijaya Imperial Palace. But before we started, please click like, subscribe, and push the notification button and share this video to all of your friends and family. Thank you. According to the Kedukan Bukit inscription, which dates back to 605 Saka or 683 AD, Sriwijaya Empire was first established around Palembang area on the banks of the Musi River. This inscription stated that King Dapuntahyang came from Minanga Tamuan. The exact location of Minanga Tamuan is still being debated. The theory of Palembang as the place where Sriwijaya first started was put forward by John Codes and supported by Pierre-Yves Mangouin. Apart from Palembang, other places such as Muaro Jambi on Batanghari River in Jambi Province, Indonesia, and Muara Takus on the confluence of the right and left Kampar Rivers in Riau are also suspected of being the capital of Sriwijaya. So there are three places that is as good contestant for capital city of Sriwijaya Empire. The first one is according to Kedukan Bukit inscription is the Palembang area, and the other is Muaro Jambi, and the other is Muara Takus in Riau. Muaro Jambi. Jambi is on the banks of the Batanghari River and not on the Musi River on Palembang as previously assumed. The archaeological site includes 8 excavated temples over an area of approximately 12 square kilometers, stretching 7.5 kilometers along the Batanghari River, as well as 80 menapo or mounds of unrestored temple ruins. The Muaro Jambi site has a Mahayana Vajrayana Buddhist pattern. This suggests that the site was a center of Buddhist learning, which is attributed to the famous Buddhist scholar Swarnadwivi Dharmakirti from the 10th century. Historical record from China also mentioned that Sriwijaya housed thousands of monks. So this also the places is suitable for the location of Sriwijaya Empire capital city in Muaro Jambi, because they have a legacy of some temple ruin that some experts say that this is where the center of the Buddhist learning in Southeast Asia. And according to admin, predict that Sriwijaya Empire capital city is move around for century, maybe from the first one is from Jambi, or the last one is they move to Palembang area, or maybe the first one is Palembang area and then they move to Jambi. It's still on question, but Sriwijaya maybe move their capital city so many times, and then you can imagine they can choose where their location of capital city, since they are a big huge empire. So they will choose where the proper of capital city to avoid the enemy attack, and also to have the best environment. Like now Indonesia planning to move their capital city from Jakarta to Kalimantan. However, in 2013, archaeological research conducted by the University of Indonesia discovered several religious sites in dwelling in Muaro Jambi. This suggests that the initial center of Sriwijaya may have been located in the Batanghari River in Muaro Jambi Regency. Jambi on the banks of the Batanghari River and not on the Musi River as previously assumed. The archaeological site include 8 excavated temple over an area of approximately 12 square kilometers, stretching 7.5 kilometers along the Batanghari River. Another theory proposed the opinion that Dapunta Hiang came from the east coast of the Malay Peninsula, that Chaya in Suratani, Southern Thailand, was the center of the Sriwijaya Empire. There is also an opinion that the name of the city of Chaya came from the word Cahaya in Malay. There are also those who believe that the name Chaya came from Sriwijaya, and this city is the center of Sriwijaya. This theory is mostly supported by Thailand historian, although it is generally regarded as lacking in strength. So this theory also, besides Palembang as a capital city, we have Muaro Jambi and also Muaro Takus as a capital city, and also some expert from Thailand and Malaysia claim that it could be Sriwijaya Empire capital city located in Chaya in Suratani, Southern Thailand, and also maybe in Pahang, Malaysia. But this is a lack of evidence and lack of historical and archaeological legacy, and this theory is generally regarded as lacking in strength by some historian expert. The Sriwijaya Principality has existed since 671 according to Ising record. From the Kedukan Bukit inscription in 682, it is known that this empire was under the leadership of Dapunta Hiang, the founder, the first king of Sriwijaya Empire, that he set out on a Siddhayatra holy journey to consume blessing, and he led 20,000 Sriwijaya Empire soldier and 312 people on board with 1,312 soldier on foot from Minangkabau to Jambi and Palembang. It is known that the Kedukan Bukit inscription is the oldest inscription written in Malay. Scholars and experts of history suggest that this inscription adapted the Indian orthography for writing this inscription. Also, Chinese chronicle contain much information of the existence of Sriwijaya Empire. In the 7th century, the Chinese noted that there were two kingdoms, namely Melayu and Kedah, which were part of the Sriwijaya Empire. Based on the Kota Kapur inscription, which is dated 686, found on the island of Bangka, this empire or Sriwijaya Empire has controlled the southern part of Sumatra, the island of Bangka to Belitung. This inscription also mentioned that Sri Jayanasa, the king, has launched a military expedition to punish Java Island who did not serve Sriwijaya. This even coincided with the fall of Taruma Nagara in West Java and Holing or Kalinga Kingdom in Central Java, which was most likely due to Sriwijaya's attack. It is possible that what is meant by Bumi Jawa is Tarumanagara Kingdom. Sriwijaya Empire grew and succeeded in controlling maritime trade routes in the Malacca Strait, the western part of the Java Sea, and possibly also the Gulf of Thailand. In the 8th century, Langkasuka on the Malay Peninsula became the part of the Sriwijaya Empire. In the following period, Panpan and Trambalinga, located north of Langkasuka, were also under Sriwijaya influence. Apart from the that, the Tanjore inscription in the India, dated 130 AD, also contain much of list of the Sriwijaya Empire area. I think that's all for me at this point. Thank you for your kind attention. Before we conclude this video, please click like, subscribe, and push notification button, and also leave a comment and share this video to all of your friends and family. Thank you for your kind attention. See you on my next video. Thank you.